So we have another pig's head. This is part of our Thanksgiving dinner.
American Thanksgiving.
American Thanksgiving. We do the turkey on the Canadian one.
Yes.
And
this is gonna be your appetizer, or one of them.
What is it?
We're making pig's head torchon from David Chang's recipe from his Mama Fuku cookbook.
What is a torchon?
It is like meat. we'll find out, won't we?
Yeah.
It's like rolled up and then you eat it. And it's,
yeah.
But to put it in words, it's just too much to ask.
Maybe like a head cheese. And this guy is boiled up first.
Yeah, that's what we're doing now. Here are some of like the hairs that we're gonna have to singe off. It's using the blowtorch that he got me for making creme brulee a couple years ago.
I think that's all that he has.
Yeah, he's not too hairy actually. So.
Yeah, they're shaved down. The other one's short enough. We don't have to worry about it.
Mm-hmm. So now he's gonna go in the pot.
Well, that smells. That burnt hair. Yeah, I think we're gonna save his ears again. Oh, that fit easier this time.
Smaller head.
Yeah. So we're toasting the chilies, part of peanut mole we're making, a Rick Bayless recipe. It's going to be for some roasted quail.
Grilled quail.
Grilled quail. That's going to be our Thanksgiving entree. So we have to do a bunch of things today.
We had to get ready for tomorrow.
Yeah. So we have some chipotle, roasted tomatoes, the onions, garlic, and big chopped peanuts. Our final ingredient are these ancho chilies that we just soaked for about the last half hour.
So now we're frying the puree. Makes me cough kind of.
It does have some spicy fumes.
So now we've added some more chicken stock, some red wine, and vinegar, and now it has to simmer for about 45 minutes.
So now we're getting started on another dish for tomorrow. It's a chilled avocado soup.
Curried, chilled, all sorts of cream. So our soup is going in the pot and it's cooked and we've added the cream, and then tomorrow right before serving we're just going to add some lemon juice.
Powerhouse of the kitchen.
You're the powerhouse of the kitchen. That's the kitchen powerhouse.
Indestructible.
Oh, man, we have a pretty weak ass kitchen. That's the powerhouse. Go. Go. I'm cheerleading. Come on, team.
The powerhouse is bending.
Whoa! Dude, I think he lost his ear.
Something fell off there. Not his ear, just a chunk of him.
Just a chunk? Is that his ear?
These are his cheeks.
Oh, he looks funny, like he's got hair on or something.
Hair.
I don't know.
Ears.
Anyways, we're taking his ears off so that we can cook them separately again. So David's not separating the meat and the fat from like the bone and nasty stuff.
Like this. This tongue looks way bigger and better than the last pig head's tongue we had.
That one cooked way longer.
Yeah, it fell apart. This one, we still have to peel it, but at least it's intact. Basically, you set out a bunch of fat on the shrink wrap, and then you put the meat inside of your nice wall of fat. It's not health food, but...
No, it is not.
But it should be tasty. It's nice because we have, like, the little pieces of skin. Or bigger pieces, so it should make the rolling go easier. So Nicole's just putting down a meat on top of our blanket of fat.
We have really no idea what we're doing. I don't feel too confident at this point.
I feel pretty good. This is makes sense, right? It's supposed to be rolled in fat. And the meat tastes good already. We've already seasoned it. So now, rolling up time.
I knew it was going to be hard to roll, and it was. And it's definitely thicker on this end than this one.
Yeah.
So our technique is quite off.
The whole thing is quite huge. I imagined it being like only like a smaller diameter.
Yes.
This thing's like as big as like a hamburger on that side. We'll see. Then we have to bread it and fry it up tomorrow. But for now, it's just going in the fridge. Our first course of the day. It's avocado chilled soup. Happy Thanksgiving. It's good.
Do you like it?
I like it better than cucumber soup.
I prefer a cucumber soup, to be honest.
I like this. What's in it besides avocado?
Cream curry powder. Yeah. What you taste is curry powder.
Yeah. It's very simple.
Yeah.
Second course. This time, Nicole made some mojitos, and we're having microwave potato chips.
Oh, very minty. Is Jule?
Mojito.
Mojito.
We're doing all of our favorites today because my mom's in town, so we're cooking pig's ears.
It's part of our next course with the pig's ears, we're frying some little quail eggs to go on top of them. Here's our crispy baked pig's ears with little quail eggs and some tartar sauce.
I get two.
Somebody gets two.
I get
Nicole
two.
Nicole gets two. I'm surprised we didn't break a yolk. That's why there's the extra yolk. That was the test. And what do we have here?
I don't know.
Tom Collins.
It started out as a Tom Collins and then it just kind of turned into our. Oh man, the egg tastes really good on it. How's your first pig's ear, Mom? Do you share our enthusiasm or not so much?
It's very good.
Here's our torchon, all solidified, kind of.
Gelatin,
yeah.
So now we're gonna bread it and deep fry it.
Yeah, cut it into little discs and put it in the oil.
That looks so good. That's awesome. Man, that is wicked. I'm super excited now. That stuff, it's supposed to be cherries in Mama Fuku, but that's my cousin Lisa's habanero jelly.
Oh, she made it?
Yeah, she made it.
From scratch.
Scratch.
All right.
I think it's really good though.
Yeah, no, I think we did a decent.
I'm surprised, it actually worked out.
Yeah.
These are the quail that we're gonna be eating.
They're so weird looking.
They're so little. They're so cute.
They look so funny.
I know.
I like it.
I like it too. And along with that, we're making a turban squash risotto. So this is our turban squash. It looks like a mushroom from like Mario Brothers. David's having a blast quartering our turban squash. Looks like ultra fun and can't believe I'm missing out. For some reason, it smells like a cucumber.
Yeah, like quite strongly. Like, it's very strange.
Very recognizably cucumbery.
Yeah.
It's weird. It's got such thin walls up there, it's gonna be kind of like a nightmare to peel.
Thin walls, really fat, weird seeds.
I'm not loving it so far.
I love the smell.
Why don't you get a cucumber then?
Here's our final course, the our final entree. This is our entree. The quail. They're so cute and tiny. With a peanut mole sauce.
And a turban squash risotto that might be disaster risotto.
Yeah, we'll have to wait and see on that one.
I really like the quail. They're really yummy and not overcooked. And the sauce is nice. And actually the disaster risotto isn't as bad as I thought.
Yeah, it's not a disaster at all.
Especially not at this stage of the evening. Everything tastes just great.